that's the big one. This is the main event.
And this is more of a fight than a wrestling match, Titty.
You know, I'm going to have to agree with you on that.
It's the 2014 Now or Never live from the Battle Zone in Georgetown, Illinois. And tonight, UWC champion Harker Dirge puts the title on the line against the powder keg Jimmy Karryt in Halloween Horrors.
Cecil Cerveza against the man who always takes it to 11, Konrad. I, folks, am Shawn Douglaz, and I will be joined by John Stone momentarily. We have a great night of action planned out for you. And here I am being joined at the moment by Mr. John Stone. Mr. John Stone, how is it doing tonight?
It's been decent, I'll say that much.
You're a man of many masks tonight, aren't you?
Oh, exactly, but you're getting the number one, baby.
That's right. So here we have Cecil Cerveza and Konrad. A pretty good rivalry's actually been going on between these two as of late, from what I see.
Well, actually, when you think about it, yeah, the rivalry is between Cecil Cerveza and Konrad, but at the same time, the rivalry, if you will, between Cecil and his own mentor, I guess, his own boss, Dickie Wabash, that's been brewing for a while now.
Absolutely. As you all know, Cecil Cerveza has kind of been on a downward spiral ever since losing the UBC Championship to Harker Dirge. And I think Dickie Wabash is really starting to question things. Last year, we all know that he fired Konrad out of the agency, but I think he's starting to question himself because Conrad's been stepping it up, and Cecil's been pretty much dropping the ball as of late.
Well, it's not only that, but think back to 1 year ago at this event. 1 year ago, Cecil Cerveza, who is still had all of us rocking from the decision to turn away from Jason V and join up with Dickie Wabash, had that horrendous, if you will, brutal chairs match with his former best friend.
Yes, I mean, you said it perfectly. It was very much brutal. There were chairs all over the place. And on that night, we seen the rise of Cecil as he knocked off his former best friend, Jason B. And then he went on to win the championship, but then lost it very shortly after. And he hasn't been able to regain himself since.
Konrad working over the arm, very smart move there. If you notice, Dickie Wabash on the outside is not running around. Drops him down again. He's not running around trying to get with the fans and get in their face anymore and yell at them and yelling for some support for Cecil. He's just kind of standing there.
Yeah, I think it's more so that he's kind of scouting out Cecil right now. He's been really disappointed in him as of late. And, I mean, I don't know. I think there might be trouble in paradise.
Well, it's like last week's edition of UWC Online. Dickie Wabash looked straight at Cecil and said, I had to fire Konrad. Don't make me have to fire you as well.
And then if you notice, Konrad faced Cecil Cerveza and surprisingly got the victory over him.
Shot to the midsection there by Konrad. Very nice knee break. Well, neck breaker, actually.
Yes.
Neck breaker into the knee. That's where I got to
see. Yeah. And ever since Conrad's got released from... He went for it all and got nothing out of that. But ever since Conrad's been fired from the talent agency, he's just got fire lit under him, and he's literally what his name says he is. He takes it up to 11 every night.
Takes him down, Luke Edge press, firing away with the rapid fire shots.
And another one going after him. The crowd is fully behind Konrad tonight.
Oh, tonight they've been behind Konrad ever since he came back here. And now Cecil Cerveza, this is a match that was supposed to have happened last week, and Konrad got the victory last week.
Yes, yes. Oh my God.
Larry into the back of the head, sends Cecil to the outside.
He nearly took his head off there.
So much action ahead for us here tonight at Now or Never.
It's going to be a great night tonight. Well, as you look at it right now, normally Dickie Wabash, if his combatants are down, he normally goes to them to try to help them.
Oh, exactly.
He's not. He's just basically telling Cecil, you know, you're on your own tonight.
I'm just out here for moral support. I'm not trying to help you out. I'm not trying to get you advantages. You got to do this on your own.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Backhand to the face. Running STO out of the corner.
That has become basically Cecil Cerveza's bread and butter. You see him do that all the time, and it works.
Good habit here. Konrad kicks out of two.
Do you think Konrad has gotten in the head of Cecil Cerveza since the last edition of UWC Online?
Oh, I believe at some aspects Konrad has definitely gotten inside Cecil Cerveza's head, but in the others, I believe it's Cecil's own frustration and the fact that he keeps getting screamed at and yelled at by Dickie Wabash while he's got to watch Dickie and Blake Reed run off to all this fame, fortune, and glory.
Exactly, exactly. Blake's basically Dickie's guy now, and it used to be Cecil, and I think Cecil kind of feels neglected, but there's nobody really to blame but himself.
Sleeper hold applied now. He's trying to get a submission hold victory. Cutting the blood flow off to the brain. Almost a variation of a sleeper side headlock.
At times, we've seen Cecil be really aggressive, but then he kind of gets over-aggressive, and that sometimes costs him his matches.
Wait a second. Take a look at this. Cecil's distracting the referee, thinking that Dickie's going to walk over and maybe slap him or choke him, but he's not doing it. Look at this.
This, in my opinion, is what you call tough luck. Dickie's wanting to do the best for Cecil, but Cecil needs to do it himself. He needs to prove that he is that elite guy again.
But he took his eyes off the ball, and Konrad is going to try and capitalize on it.
I think I've seen a tooth fly out.
Rolls him back into the ring. Dickie Wabash just walked away, shrugged his shoulders, and told him, do it yourself.
Oh, my
Very
God.
Nice sit-down powerbomb variation into a pin.
I seen Dickie get a little bit excited about that move right there. Now, do you think if Cecil loses to Konrad again tonight, do you think that's going to basically sever the ties between Cecil and Dickie?
I don't know. I mean, this is a very weird game that the two of them are playing. I understand you say it's tough love, but we saw what happened the last time somebody tried to show Cecil tough love, and that was Jason B 1 year ago.
It was, yes, and I mean, Cecil was a very dangerous man at the time, and he still very well could be, but he's just got to basically get over that hump and get back on the winning side of things.
I almost equate it to the way musicians talk about it or other athletes and celebrities. They fight so much. It's like being a college basketball player.
Mm-hmm.
You fight so much on a college level to make yourself good enough to where one day maybe you could join the NBA.
Absolutely.
Then after you join that NBA, you don't try as hard anymore.
You think that you've made it to the dance, basically.
Exactly. Once you get to the spot that you're in, like Cecil winning the title earlier this year, isn't it? He won the title, but the initial feeling of that, in most people, you would think they would say, I want it even more.
Absolutely.
But then there's that other side of the spectrum of people that say, I finally reached my goal, so I'm going to chalk it back a bit. And they don't understand, you can't just, you know, rest on your laurels. You can't hit the brakes. You got to keep going.
You hit the nail right on the head, and I think that's exactly what happened with Cecil Cerveza when he shocked the world and pinned Harker Dirge. He was the only man to do that, you know, and...
Oh, misses.
Oh, my God!
Jumping neckbreaker out of the corner!
That got the crowd sparked.
The crowd sparked, and Cecil's world rocked.
But I honestly believe that Dickie has really lost his confidence in Cecil Cerveza, and he's really questioning himself if he did fire the right man, because Konrad has been on the uproar, Cecil has been on the downfall.
Oh, exactly. Shawn Rife on six, they got to the count of 10, fighting to be the first man back up. They broke up the count.
They're exchanging blows.
Fighting from their knees.
Oh,
that one, nice, Konrad.
Konrad comes out swinging. Look at those forearm shots to the head.
Bounces off, rolling kick to the midsection. Hits the ropes, comes in, shoulder block. Forearm shot to the face, gonna try it again, coming off. Gets out of the way.
Oh my gosh!
The Superman elbow, I guess you'd say.
Yeah, that'd be pretty much it.
Somehow gets the shoulder up at two.
I thought he actually knocked him out, honestly. It looked like he knocked him out.
But from our vantage point, it looked brutal.
Yeah, it did.
Konrad's the first one up, getting his air back in the corner.
But he's letting Cecil, you know, get some air in him and get back to his feet. That could be a downfall for Konrad.
Yeah, he's setting something up right here. Coming in, launches in. Nice, jumping elbow in the corner.
Oh, what a counter.
Goes for roll the dice. Backslide pin, this got him the victory last week. Roll over.
Oh, it didn't work that time.
Ducks under the buzzsaw kick.
Oh, my God.
One, but Cecil's foot on the bottom rope.
Great ring awareness by Cecil Cerveza, but Konrad thinks he's won.
This crowd thought he won. This crowd was up and ready to cheer for Konrad. Good ring awareness on the part of Cecil Cerveza. And look at Dickie, he's clapping for him.
I can understand why Konrad thought he won. He's beaten several people with that move.
Well, let's be honest, we all thought he had it there.
Absolutely, I did. He's wasting time, though. He needs to stay on it.
I think he's going to try and hit another one of those moves to put him away again.
Could he be setting up for another one of the RKOs?
He's cold and ready to strike. Vintage Konrad. Cecil tosses him off.
Good counter by Cecil Cerveza.
Could be going for that buzzsaw kick. He's eyeing him.
If he hits it.
There it is.
Why isn't Cecil going for the pin now?
I don't know if he wants to go for the pin just yet. He wants to inflict a little more damage.
He wants to punish him, basically.
Punish him for that victory last week is all I can think of. Another buzzsaw kick?
Maybe this one's for Dickie.
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh.
Nothing but bone on skull that time.
Getting up though.
Still going for the pin, and Cecil, Dickie's on the outside looking at Cecil thinking, what are you doing? Go for the pin. Konrad's trying to tell him, look, I don't want another one. Oh!
He hit him with a third one, but that's got to be it.
Oh no. Four!
Oh my gosh.
Four buzzsaw kicks. Look at that man. Oh no.
This could be the roll of the dice.
Roll the dice.
And he hit it.
He lays him down.
Once you hit that, nobody gets up.
And he got it.
So you're what? There you have it, folks. Cecil Cerveza gets the win over Konrad.
And look at it right now. Look at Dickie Wabash. I think he finally got through to him.
I believe you're right, John Stone. Cecil did that all on his own. He did not have help. And that's what Dickie wanted.
The picture you're seeing right now, we haven't seen in months.
Folks, in this match, the rules are you can only win by beating
start of the UWC online title match. It is featuring the champion, Frank Wyatt, versus the challenger, Mark Vandy, and the first ever in the UWC history, a bull rope match. Well, I am joined up here at the moment by Dr. Nick. Dr. Nick, it's nice to see you again. How you doing tonight?
Oh, pretty good. Glad to be here, Sean.
Well, you came on the perfect night. It's looking to be a very, very good night ahead.
This is definitely a unique match because you can't win by pinfall or submission.
Exactly. The only way you can win is by basically dragging your opponent and touching all four of the top turnbuckles in succession without being interrupted. So you may get up to three, but if the other competitor stops you in the process, you have to start back over.
Plus, if you really think about it, you can use that bull rope as a weapon.
Absolutely. You could choke the man. You could hit him with, you could hit him with a big old cowbell that's in the center. I mean, these two, Frank Wyatt and Mark Vandy, have been on just a complete collision course ever since Frank Wyatt became UWC online champion. And Mark Vandy has stated that tonight is his night. He is going to leap the hurdle that is Frank Wyatt and win the championship. It's too early to tell right now, but anything can happen.
Well, what's interesting about Frank Wyatt is not only is he a big guy, but he can move around just like the rest of them.
Absolutely.
That's what's so unique about him.
Sometimes I wonder if Frank Wyatt is actually the weight that he says he is.
Yeah.
He can fly around like some of the guys that are only 180. I mean, he is an all around. Each of them have touched a turnbuckle. Each of them have touched two now. Oh.
Frank Wyatt is not so easy.
Me personally, I have never seen in the independent circuit a bull rope match. So I'm very excited to see what goes down in this.
Oh, absolutely. I've never seen anything like it. And, you know, it's going to be an interesting match because of the fact that you have two differently skilled wrestlers. They're both two different styles.
Well, there you see the bull rope went into play right there, knocking the big man down. And now Mark Vandy basically smells blood. He's going after Frank Wyatt.
Plus, if you think about it, the referee definitely has a difficult job because, you know, with the damage that the bull rope can do, he may have to use at his discretion. You know, one of the individuals could be injured.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, Mark Vandy going fast, but, well, he stops right there. Apparently he didn't feel he had Frank Wyatt down for enough time, so he stopped, which could be smart on his part.
Well, it's too early to tell right now, but just the way the match is going right now, I favor Frank Wyatt.
Well, it's kind of hard to go against Frank Wyatt if you look at it. I mean, this guy, he's a monster. He's 380-plus pounds. He moves around like he's a cruiserweight.
Yeah.
I mean, basically, since he's came on the scene in UWC, he's almost been untouchable. He's got a pretty good record. Mark Vandy, on the other hand, kind of started out slow. Had some significant losses, but he's really picked his game up lately, and especially last week on UWC Online in the big six-man main event, he actually pinned Frank Wyatt in the center of the ring.
Very true.
Not many people can say they've done that.
Yes. And, you know, Mark Vandy definitely has something above other individuals, and he's not underestimated Frank Wyatt whatsoever.
He has not at all. He knows he's going up against a monster, but he's willing. Oh, that's just the power right there, Frank Wyatt showing. But Mark Vandy, he's one of those guys that, you know, is a realist. Oh, man.
He clocked him with that cowbell.
Yeah, he did. And like I said, he lost a lot of matches at first, but then he beat some pretty good competition. He knocked off former, you know, full-time UWC wrestler in Matt Cage. He's even knocked off our own Jason V, which is not an easy task.
No, absolutely not.
And he's one of the few men that has pinned Frank Wyatt in the center of the ring.
speaking of cowbell, Frank Wyatt does not fear the Reaper.
Oh, wow. You did a Blue Oyster Cult reference
yes,
right
I
there.
Yes, I went there.
For the win. Oh, there he's wanting to use the rope to his advantage. And you know what? In any other scenario, that would not be allowed. But that is perfectly legal in this match.
Well, both individuals know that they can use the bull rope and the cowbell to their advantage any way they want to.
Absolutely.
And Mark Vandy definitely has taken advantage of that.
But the thing about it is, if let's say Frank Wyatt is knocked out, how in the world, oh wow, how in the world is Mark Vandy going to pull him across the ring to touch all the corners?
Yeah, it's not like he's going to throw him on his back.
Physical matchup so far. I can't believe I'm actually saying this, but Frank Wyatt has actually kind of been dominated a little bit at the fair time, but I say that and now he comes back with a fury.
Well, as we've said before, Frank Wyatt's one of those guys that, you know, he has such power and stamina that normally big guys don't have.
Absolutely.
He paces himself and he puts himself in the ring to where he needs to be.
He had a full head of steam. Oh my gosh! That was like a rolling burrito.
Wow. I love burritos, Sean.
I was gonna say, it's kind of making me hungry. How would you feel being on the mat and seeing that coming at you full force?
I don't even want to think about that. I'd be very scared.
Up here comes Frank Wyatt. He's got two.
Wyatt is very smart by keeping him right in the middle.
Absolutely. He's got three. Oh, but Vandy, he's blocking that fourth corner. There it is! Mark Vandy tried to block him and hit him with that big boot, but Frank Wyatt used his noggin, outsmarted him, and got the fourth corner. Dr. Nick.
Oh, wow, that was fantastic.
As you heard Mr. John Stone say, winner and still UWC Online champion, Mr. Frank Wyatt. Now it's going to be interesting to see where Frank Wyatt and Mark Vandy go from here.
Yeah, I definitely don't think Vandy's done with Frank Wyatt.
I don't believe so either. He'll bounce back, but like I said, trying to take down Frank Wyatt is a tall order for anybody.
Oh, absolutely.
All right, Dr. Nick, we got John Stone down there making the announcement of the match. Very, very personal. Very, very, you know, how do you explain it? It's a very personal matter right now between these two. Honestly, you can probably barely hear me over the crowd. Two brothers turned enemies. It's, I don't know, it's, I'm kind of a loss for words for this match.
Well, I mean, they were multi-time tag team champions, very close friends. Like you said, they were brothers, and now both of them are basically going to tear each other limb by limb.
It's going to be interesting. Oh, my gosh! Down goes Dickie! Down goes Dickie!
My God!
That is the way you start the match. Oh, man, Travis showing no mercy. Wabash literally just got his jaw jacked by Travis Weir. Mr. Johnstone, what in the world just happened down there?
Oh, trust me, if you've been watching all these past few weeks, months if you will, ever since Blake Reed decided to turn his back not only on UWC, but on his former best friend Travis Weir, this has just been brewing. This fight has been waiting to happen for months.
Oh my. Dickie is literally out.
I'm not arguing. I'm not screaming.
I'm not either. I mean, Travis.
Wait a minute. Watch out. Watch out. Oh.
Wow. You know, this is bothering Travis.
Oh, hey, Dr. Nick. Didn't even realize you were here.
In your opinion, John, who do you favor in this match?
I can't have an opinion. That's the problem. I've been so close with the both of these men. We, all three of us together, have rode up and down the road with each other in the same car sharing stories. So this is actually kind of personal for me. I can't choose sides.
I'll wait for this to be done. Crowd's really into this right now.
I will say this, though. I was just as disappointed as everybody else when Blake Reed decided to make the decision that he did and join up with the talent agency.
Well, and you know what, John Stone, I was going to bring that point up.
Oh!
You personally know these two better than anybody. You know, I have also been in the car with you three numerous times, taking numerous road trips.
Yeah.
And you guys had such a great bond.
Oh, yeah.
You guys were basically a family. And, I mean, it's and you ask even Travis's wife and kids, you and Blake Reed were a part of their family.
Exactly.
And I know it hurt all of them, it hurt you, and it especially hurt Travis when,
oh my gosh,
when Blake did the unthinkable and turned his back on his brothers.
I don't even think it's about jealousy anymore. I think it's literally Blake Reed was brainwashed by Dickie Wellness, plain and simple. He promised him things, and he took him under his wing, and look what happened.
Well, as much as a personal issues I have vested in this match, I'm going to try and be, you know, nonchalant here. I'm going to call it right down the middle. And let's not forget, it was last week when Travis Weir was able to nail that sunny side up on Blake Reed. And because of that, I've had people tell me that Blake Reed's actually still sporting a somewhat injured shoulder here in this match tonight.
Well, I can completely imagine why. I mean, you've seen it yourself. I mean, that would put any normal man down for the count.
Exactly. And speaking of down for the count, Dickie Wabash, I don't think he's moved a muscle since... Wait, I saw the foot raise up a little bit.
I got a little... that's kind of a spit in the face.
Look at that. Blake Reed's version of a big stupid elbow.
I kind of went a little overzealous when that started, when Dickie got super kicked. I kind of, you know, I'm supposed to be impartial, but that kind of made me smile and, you know, cheer a little bit myself. But I gotta be impartial to this completely.
Well, you know, this is Halloween. This is the season of candy, and I guess sometimes you feel like a nut and sometimes you don't.
Oh, wow. I didn't know we were going for an Almond Joy reference, but why not? We've had that. We've had a Blue Oyster Cult reference.
Wow.
Might as well do some more.
That's right. Blake Reed in the ring right now. Blake Reed, I mean, who does that? Seriously.
Well, you know what? Honestly, these two have went on after, you know, basically splitting up as a tag team and doing their own thing. They kind of went on two similar but different roads. As you all know, Travis Weir last year won the first ever Horizon Cup tournament.
Exactly.
Then a year later, Blake Reed wins the Horizon Cup tournament.
Yeah, think about that. The irony of that.
Exactly. But the thing about it is that Dickie Wabash pointed it out when he was talking to Dr. Nick. You know, he said that...
Oh!
Massive clothesline. He said that Travis won the tournament and then basically dropped the ball. Blake Reed has won the tournament and has been a force to be reckoned with. So... agree with what Dickie Wabash says, but he might be right.
But we got to remember, this is not the good-looking guy of Travis Weir that showed up here tonight. He showed up with his game face, and he's ready to fight.
This is the Travis Weir from 1 year ago, 2013, when he won the Horizon Cup Tournament by beating both Bo Sawyer and Christian Rose in the same night. This is the Travis Weir that, along with the man he's in the ring with right now, Blake Reed, won multiple tag team championships in different promotions.
Absolutely.
This team went to battle with the likes of Attitude Inc., the Kentucky Buffet, Honey Crossbody. He could have it here. Only a two count. Well, they went to battle with such teams as I said. Attitude Inc. to Kentucky Buffet.
Team Sexy.
Cookies and Cream. Team Sexy. So many more. The Hooligans. Even went to battle with them.
Yeah.
Just to see them as they are right now, I can't believe it.
Well, if you remember right, last year at this very event, at Now or Never, these two had a matchup. But more about Travis was looking for the respect to show that he was the elite guy. And after the match was over, they shook hands. They were still brothers. 1 year later, they are bitter enemies.
Exactly. Wait a minute. Pin attempt here. Two count.
You know, normally, I would say that the longer a match goes, the seasoned veteran would have the advantage. But in this instance, both of them are seasoned veterans.
Well, not just the fact that both of them are seasoned veterans. Wait a second here. Double axe handle to the back. This isn't going to be good.
Oh my.
He's going to powerbomb out of the corner.
He didn't get all he wanted out of it, but it could have been enough.
I think his shoulders kind of gave out. I mean, it's understandable.
I think that move hurt Travis Moore as well.
As I'm saying here, though, I'm not just saying it's the advantage of whoever's got the most experience. Think of this. Travis Weir learned almost everything he knows in the ring from Blake Reed.
Absolutely.
So he knows Blake Reed better than anybody else in the back.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Look out!
Sidewinder moonsault!
Holy!
He hasn't done that in so long!
Oh, my gosh. How did Blake Reed kick out of that?
320-plus pounds with a Sidewinder moonsault!
Said some choice words that probably would not be allowed on this DVD.
I don't think Travis can believe he didn't put him away. Open palm thrust shot, slaps to the face.
Oh my gosh!
He just got punked, and there's the short super kick. Could have it. Oh, come on.
He had him. He had him. Blake Reed is still down.
Why is he not knocked out still? Ridiculous.
Should have known Dickie Wabash is going to stick himself in this.
Exactly. It comes with these two. He's the one that started it all. Take him out. Lay him out.
Oh, here it is.
That's it. Get him.
Oh,
no.
Oh, you got to be kidding me.
Blake Reed utilizing Travis's own move, the short super kick. He took his eyes off the ball.
Had him beat,
but he took his eyes off the ball. I gotta call it the way I saw it. Dickie Wabash gets himself involved.
I'm flabbergasted at that. Travis controlled the whole match. He had Blake Reed beat.
Well, doesn't it figure? As I said, Dickie Wabash is the root of all the evil between these two. Dickie Wabash is the one that caused this. How fitting is it that he factors in the most heavily in this match tonight?
You're right, John Stone.
Can you get the warden in your office, Dr. Nick? And I said, hell no.
Whoa. I don't know. I don't know if I'd want him anywhere near us. Well, the fans right off the bat showing what they think of the warden. The Warden's whole intent is to get rid of so-called cartoon characters in the UWC. And when you go cartoon characters, one of the most flamboyant men that you can talk about is Jason V.
Yeah, as we can tell, the Warden hates fun.
Yeah, and Jason V loves fun. Speaking of a fun-loving guy, Mr. John Stone is back, shedding a pumpkin king, or pumpkin head mask, whatever it was.
It was pumpkin head, get it right.
Same thing, the pumpkin is on your head.
A pumpkin that's on your head is not the same thing as a pumpkin that's a king.
You might want to, but didn't you always want to be a king?
You've lost this argument before you even started.
Oh, calm down, Simba.
This match happening due to the fact of something that I was actually there and saw live in person a few weeks ago, trying to get an interview with Jason V, and all of a sudden the Warden, out of nowhere, just shows up, starts fighting, starts beating up Jason V, and then slams a steel trash can down on his head.
Yeah, this Warden, he's a very, very mysterious human being. If anybody watched the UWC Initiate program, his little vignette that went on, I mean, it kind of even scared me a little bit. He's all about getting rid of the cartoon characters, and like I told Dr. Nick, when you want to go to the fun-loving characters here in the UWC, who's the number one guy that's always mentioned?
Exactly.
Jason V.
Body slam sends Jason V down. The Warden actually standing tall right now.
Well, the Warden's got to realize this is not going to be a walk in the park. This is not the fun-loving Jason V that walked in the ring. He's ready to go at it. This is more of a vicious side of Jason V.
Well, that's a perfect example right there. Oh, man. Forearms, elbows. Jason V is on fire right now. I don't know what happened there. The Warden kind of overjumped himself. And Jason V made him pay for it. Uh-oh. Oh. That's veteran ring work right there by Jason V.
Look at him! Suicide dive to the outside!
Oh, he's not done yet.
Oh, Jason V's going to the top
floor. Look at the crowd here in the battle zone.
They love Jason V here.
Jason V in front of his hometown of Georgetown, Illinois.
He always seems to feed off being here in Georgetown, being in front of his hometown crowd. It always seems to make him, you know, take it up a little bit more of a notch than he normally does.
Oh! Wait a minute, climbing up to that top rope. Dives off, takes him over with a wristlock takeover. The Warden now doesn't know what he's got himself in for.
Well, the Warden, he likes to fight, but right now he's being straight up out-wrestled.
Nice shot there right to the throat. So many fans jam-packed here in the battle zone wearing costumes for the Halloween season. I even think I see the Yeti!
Yeah, what, didn't you say something about that being a relative of yours?
Don't want to go into it.
Hey, and I heard the little comment you made about me up there saying that's me after the show. Come on now.
I legitimately thought it was you.
Come on now.
They fooled me. I had no idea. Creepy guy with a hood over his head and it's pitch black at night. I didn't know what to say.
Terrible idea.
Head first into the top turnbuckle there. Warden now driving those shoulders into the midsection on Jason V.
What do you do with a guy that basically you have no idea what he's going to do? Jason V usually has an idea of what his opponent is all about, but the Warden, you never know what he's going to pull out.
Exactly, but that's where the experience factor of being a professional wrestler in the business as long as Jason V has comes into play. Something everybody likes to call work with what you got, thinking on the fly.
Well, you hit the nail on the head there, and honestly, I don't think there's anybody really in the business that's better at doing that than Jason V. However, this Warden character, I still haven't quite figured him out yet.
I don't think anybody has. I don't even think he has.
You're right, because he sits there and he argues with himself. What is he saying to himself?
Well, it's the voices inside of his own head. He's arguing to himself, whether he's arguing to Phage, whether he's arguing to Oxycontin, Taylor, any one of the other voices in his head. The Warden is the leader of all those voices. The Warden's the one that holds down the fort inside the prison in the man's own mind that holds everybody else there.
Well, of course, we're in the Halloween season right now. And honestly, the Warden, the character of the Warden reminds me a lot of, well, we're going to go to the Halloween genre, of Michael Myers. I mean, Michael Myers, he had the voices in his head telling him to do very, very horrible things. And that's kind of the way, I mean, the Warden's kind of shaping out there.
Yeah, so but I think even Michael Myers had a soul. I'm not so sure about him.
That's true.
Michael Myers had a soul, but he killed his own family. Your argument is invalid. Neck wrench applied now.
Well, he hasn't killed all his family, just to let you know. Just throwing that in there. Hashtag win.
Yeah.
Me. Nobody knows that series around here better than me. I watch it all the time. I watch it religiously. I know you're a horror movie expert, John Stone. I won't touch you on that.
I'm watching this match right now, face first into the second turnbuckle. Almost knocked the mask right off the face of the Warden.
You know,
double axe handle.
Jason B could be a scary individual as well when he gets on it.
Oh, he proved that many months ago in that battle with Jimmy Karryt and Harker Dirge.
That I Quit match, he showed us a side of himself that we've never seen before.
Wait a minute. Brings him in. Hammerlock DDT.
He's put guys away with that move.
Kick out at two.
A little bit of frustration in Jason B's face. He's not really sure what it's going to take to put this man away.
Well, if you think about it, Jason B is trying to work this match. He's trying to wrestle this match to the best of his abilities. But at the same time, the anger that's running through the man's veins over what happened to him weeks ago to start this whole thing between himself and the Warden. The attack. The fact that that attack caused him to lose a match against Mark Vandy right after it happened. Having the steel trash can brought down not only across his head, but he crushed his head between that and heroic chairs and tables. It was ridiculous.
Yes. Completely agree with that. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no.
Neck breaker.
He's used that before to beat other opponents. Oh. Is this it for Jason B?
Being a little overzealous here, he should have gone for the pin right off the bat.
He lost with that move. Oh, my God.
He lost with the move. One count, and Jason B is fired up.
Oh, my gosh. The Warden cannot believe it. Nobody has ever kicked out of that, let alone a one.
Jason B did, and look at the look on his face.
Oh, crowd's really trying to get Jason B back on his feet. Uh-oh.
Dr. Nick, would you call that a surge of adrenaline or something?
Oh, yes.
He's looking to possibly hit that boot.
As we've seen this before, the unpredictability of Jason B.
Oh, high knee.
Springing off the bottom rope.
Uh-oh. What's he calling
for? He's got a knuckle lock on. He's going back to the well. He's going to try that move again, but Warden knocks him off onto that top rope.
Uh-oh.
Some sort of a super kick or something. Shot!
That was impressive.
That was desperation.
Jason B is definitely not done in this match.
Beautiful move there that sent the Warden down. Jason B, he's up in his homestead. He's up in the corner. The boot's coming.
He's calling for the big boot.
If he hits it, this one's over. Oh, wait a second. I think he was trying to block, but he accidentally ran crotch first into his forearms.
Oh, yeah. That was an inadvertent shot. Oh, my gosh.
Drops him into a pin. He got him.
Oh. I'm hurt right now.
Sort of a bittersweet victory by the Warden.
Here's the pin winner, the Warden.
happening right now. Jason B was going for the move. The Warden went down to his knees in his cowering position that he goes to, and I think inadvertently hit Jason B below the belt.
Exactly. It was an inadvertent counter,
which caused him to capitalize, and I'm so shocked, got the victory.
Well, I hate to say it, but like it or not, the Warden is the winner here tonight.
The crowd is also stunned. I'm for words.
What does this mean for UWC? Who will they go after next? Will there be any fun left?
I think he may have just took the fun out of UWC. Nick, tag team championship action going on.
The challengers are accompanied to the ring tonight by Bradley Dupree, attorney at law. And by Spencer Woods.
Watching and are kind of at a loss for words right now of how Tornado Jones is the other tag team champion, so to speak. What a lot of people don't know is that, unfortunately, due to some kind of legal work that Bradley Dupree has done and getting a hold of Aaron Matthews, I don't know what you would say his, what would you call him? Probation officer, maybe?
I guess you could say.
And something went wrong, and another, but Aaron Matthews, we don't know where he is. He's kind of just faded away. We don't know exactly where he is or when he's coming back. So that kind of left Joey O'Reilly in a spot. Hold on a second, fans. I'll explain more in just a second. Here they go.
Looking forward to all night.
Absolutely.
Because you have two high flyers against two guys that will just beat the crap out of you.
Exactly. And due to everything that happened, Joey O'Reilly was without a tag team partner going into the title match tonight against Rough Cut. Well, Sheriff Titty Nashville decided that that was not fair, so he said that Joey O'Reilly could pick his own partner to be the other half of the tag team champion.
What better partner than Tornado Jones?
Absolutely.
Especially after that awesome win last week over Alex Castle.
Yeah, surprisingly enough, Joey O'Reilly was very impressed with what Tornado Jones did and thought that he was the best suitable replacement for Aaron Matthews.
Alex Castle is no pushover, so
no,
that was
not
a big win.
Exactly. Hold on. We talk about the speed versus the power. Joey O'Reilly actually is pretty powerful himself.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, what a tag team move there.
See Joey O'Reilly, he has that tremendous upper body strength.
That was a running, standing, shooting star press on Josh Steele. Now, the thing about it is that Tornado Jones is very new to the UWC. And he was very gracious with Joey O'Reilly to even put the confidence in him, and he promised that he would not let Joey down. That being said, he's put into a big match environment against two very big guys who are the former tag team champions that were pretty much unbeatable in their stint.
John Stone said at the beginning of the match, the corn-fed beast, Bert Sawyer. That says it right there.
Exactly.
The beast.
And still, he is the real deal. He has really stepped up his game since joining Roughneck. And I'm definitely, oh my gosh, this is the power right here. As much as I love watching Joey O'Reilly, and I'm really impressed with this Tornado Jones kid, I'm not trying to sound mean or anything, but tonight I just got to give the edge to Rough Cut because, I mean, the speed only gets you so far.
Well, as the match goes on, and we've seen this in the past, yes, they are stronger, they are bigger guys, but as the pace goes on, just to Joey O'Reilly and Tornado Jones, they may be able to run circles around them.
Think that the inexperience of Tornado Jones and Joey O'Reilly are a new form tag team. Rough Cut is a well-known tag team. They know how to get it done. They know how to win. And because of one little hiccup, they lost. Their only loss was to lose the titles to Joey O'Reilly and Aaron Matthews.
Right.
But I honestly, you know, Tornado Jones, he's kind of on a high right now.
But also, sort of a side note, because of them being a newly formed tag team, Rough Cut has not had the opportunity to study their matches.
You're absolutely right. I mean, anything can happen in this situation. But another thing we haven't talked about is the two elements outside the ring in Bradley Dupree and Spencer Waltz. I mean, that's definitely an advantage for Rough Cut.
Yes. In a situation like this, you also have the disadvantage of the fact that Rough Cut was expecting Joey O'Reilly and Aaron Matthews.
Exactly.
So they were anticipating both of those guys.
Well, Bradley Dupree said he was going to make everything right.
Yes.
He said that he felt that he was the reason why Rough Cut lost the tag team titles in the first place. So whatever he may have done with Aaron Matthews, we're not sure. We haven't seen him. We haven't heard from him. Hopefully, he'll be back soon. But it took one of the main elements of that team away. And, I mean, it may work in the advantage of Rough Cut.
Well, with the managerial bordering powers of Bradley Dupree, we know Aaron Matthews was deported to Canada.
I mean, it's very possible. I hate for that to happen. You know, everybody here in Georgetown loves Aaron Matthews. Him and Joey O'Reilly were on a huge high for winning the tag titles, surprisingly. But the only problem is that Joey O'Reilly has to put his trust in someone that hasn't even been in the ring for a year here in the
WWC. Well, one of the things that I've always noticed when it comes to a guy like Tornado Jones, who is basically his identity is behind a mask, is Rough Cut going to try to take that mask off of him?
Say, oh my gosh!
Because we all know masked wrestlers are very proud of their heritage.
They are. I don't think he's going to be very proud of that uppercut he just got from Josh Steele.
Oh, that was a close one.
You know, Joey O'Reilly's biting at the bit right now to get in. He sees.
Yes. He wants a piece of Josh Steele.
He sees that his partner is, you know, being overpowered.
Well, as you said before, this is where the inexperience comes in.
Absolutely.
You have Rough, who are a cohesive team. They know when to tag in and out.
Exactly.
And Josh Steele makes sure that he's over in his corner.
And they're tagging in and out, keeping each other fresh.
Yes.
They're keeping Tornado Jones away from Joey O'Reilly. This is perfect tag team wrestling at its finest. And I'm not a big fan of Rough Cut with the way they do things, but I got to give the devil their dues because they are a very impressive tag team.
Yes. As you can see here, Joey O'Reilly's getting the crowd pumped up, which could be an advantage for Tornado Jones. We know how he feeds off the crowd.
Exactly. Oh, what's going on here? Jumps on Josh Steele's shoulders. I think that was a backwards hurricanrana, but both men landing on their head. Oh my gosh.
I think in a way, in this particular move, I think he hurt himself in the process along with Josh Steele.
He landed right on his neck. Josh Steele landed on his head.
I think the referee might want to check both of them at this point.
Well, thankfully, both of them are moving. Their extremities are moving, so I'm glad to see that. But this is the chance right now Tornado Jones needs to get to his partner.
Both of these guys need to make a tag.
Oh, and he does!
Joey O'Reilly sails in the ring. He's got both Sawyer stumbling. He's got him rocking.
Kick! Springboard kick! Only a two count, though. Both Sawyer showing why he's the corn-fed beast.
Joey O'Reilly is fired up.
Yes, he is. He's been waiting for that.
He's got to watch the power of both Sawyer, though. One wrong move, and he'll take you down.
Oh, my gosh! Huge jumping forearm! Oh, I thought that was it.
I thought my blood pressure went up there.
But Tornado Jones wanting the tag back in. He needs to rest.
I'm not sure if this is a wise decision.
He really needs to rest. But Joey gives him a chance.
I understand the young man wants a piece, but...
He wants to prove himself, but he just got overpowered for several minutes. I don't think that was a very good idea.
No. I understand the man has heart, but you gotta listen to your brain, too.
He's getting on his feet. Spencer Wallace back on the apron.
Come on, ref!
Oh, wow, Bo Sawyer says no.
He said, you stay out of this. This is my match.
Covering his friend.
I admire the young man for what he did, but...
Oh, no. They got bad intentions written all over it. Standing both men up.
Oh, this isn't good.
No, it's not. Wait, what?
What?
What the hell?
They're extending their hands?
What the hell is this? Pardon my language, but...
Wait a minute.
Tornado says he doesn't know about this.
I'm not so sure this is a good...
They shook
They're
hands.
Showing respect to the former tag team champions.
Bradley Dupree gets in the middle of the two of them. Uh-oh! What is this? And they got their former lawyer, whatever you want to call him. Oh, didn't think
that wasn't a good
no.
answer.
Oh, no.
That was very dumb.
And Tornado Jones and Joey O'Reilly are clapping for him. Have we just seen a turn of the good for Rough Cut? I can't believe what I just seen, Dr. Nick.
I don't even know what to say. But we have two tag team champions.
Absolutely, and I think they've done away with Bradley Dupree and Spencer Wallace.
Very wise decision.
It's Halloween time. There's a lot of tricks. There's a lot of treats. This right here, I can honestly say, it's a good treat for everybody for Halloween.
Three cans of Surge.
Yes, we surged it up before.
Oh, yeah.
It could even end up in the bathroom for all we know. I mean, no swirlies I want to see, but you never know nowadays. But in all seriousness, you know, Jimmy Karryt has been on this little path trying to, you know, derail Harker Dirge's champion, even trying to get in the head of Jason V to do it. Well, he didn't get the job done, so Jimmy Karryt basically said, you want something done, you do it yourself. And that's why we have it tonight. However, he has a tall task against the current champion. Hello, Mr. John Stone. Welcome back.
Thank you very much. Front face lock applied, going for a vertical suplex of sorts. Exactly what it is, but he held on.
And Dr. Nick, you know, this being a Falls Count Anywhere, said this could end up at the Subway.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. It could very well end up there.
Well, if it does, we're going down there because I need a sandwich anyway. I love the get-up that Harker Dirge came out in, the Freddy Krueger, you know.
Harker's the man of your dreams.
Exactly. And when you're a kid and that, you know, that image of Freddy Krueger gets in your head, it literally scares the you-know-what out of you. So maybe that's what he's trying to do. Maybe he's trying to get into the head of Jimmy Karryt.
Oh, there's nobody in this company that's better at playing mind games than Harker Dirge. He knows how to get under your skin and get inside your head just before the big match happens to give him that advantage.
Absolutely, absolutely.
This is definitely a perfect match for both of these guys because both of them are unpredictable. They're both brawlers. I'd say let them go at it.
Well, go ahead, Mr. Johnson.
This is not the first time that these two have faced off for the championship in the last several weeks. It was Sheriff Titty Nashville that made this match possible, that made this match happen. He knew the only way to allow these two to get their feelings out, if you will, and to fight is to take away a disqualification, take away the countouts, and tell them you can pin them anywhere in this town.
Well, if nobody's mistaken, this is not actually the first Halloween Horrors match in UWC history.
Oh, no, it's not.
There was one other one, and ironically, Harker Dirge was involved and came out the victor.
Exactly.
So Jimmy Karryt needs to watch himself because Harker knows what to do in this type of environment.
Harker's stumbling around. I guess he's been blinded by that rake to the eyes now. Karryt taking advantage of it on the outside. Choking away, but there's no DQ, so this is completely legal.
I definitely don't think we're going to see a lot of wrestling in this match.
No, definitely. This is a fight through and through.
You hit the nail right on the head when you said it's a fight. These two men, they know
each other
so well, and Harker is normally the one guy that, you know, wants to get in there and wrestle, see who's the best wrestler, but tonight, I think he's just wanting to literally beat the hell out of Jimmy Karryt.
I think he's going to hit him with the left and hit him with the right because it's a fight. It's a fight.
You're a poet and you didn't know it.
I think with this match, it's not necessarily Jimmy Karryt wants to win the match. He wants to basically end Harker Dirge's career.
Exactly.
Well, Jimmy Karrett's had this obsession over the UWC Championship ever since he lost it just a couple years ago. And he's always said that he's going to climb that mountain and get back on top. But he's always been using other people to try to do his dirty work. Well, now he's on his own, and he may be more dangerous than ever.
Jimmy Karryt and just in it. Oh, nice bulldog there.
And even if Harker Dirge does manage to retain the title, what type of shape are either one of these guys going to be at the end of this match?
Jimmy Karryt in an interview a few days ago, which you saw on UWC Initiate, stated that he's tired of somebody like Harker Dirge, who's a veteran of this business, been in it for 18 plus years. He feels that guys like him just walk into a company and are immediately handed everything on a silver platter. That's where the root of this hatred between himself and Harker Dirge comes from. I think it goes a little bit deeper than that, which you were touching on, Sean, about being wanting that title back, because back when he was champion in his 7-month reign, he was completely different than the one that we see now.
Absolutely. I mean, this Jimmy Karryt is so manipulative and...
Uh-oh, watch out!
Oh.
Knee breaker on the outside!
You know, I know Jimmy Karryt very well, obviously, and he was dangerous then, but he's even more unstable now than he was back a year ago.
Well, a perfect example of being unstable is the words that he said in the ring last week were basically said he was going to beat Harker Dirge so badly.
Uh-oh, look at this. He just ripped... I'm sorry, Dr. Nick, but he ripped a camera from a fan. Oh, my. He just broke the camera from a fan. Security, get in there.
What in the world?
We don't endorse fans getting involved in the action here. Harker, take him out. He just shattered that person's camera.
I don't condone that at all.
Oh, my God.
No, not at all. That's ridiculous.
We apologize to that fan, you know. We can't apologize enough for that. We do not condone that at all.
No, that was all Jimmy Karryt. We've got it on video documentation, too.
Well, like you said, the unstableness of Jimmy Karryt, the words he used, to beat him so badly that Harker Dirge did not want to be UWC champion anymore.
Harker Dirge going for a pin after smacking Carrot's head. Take the belt. Only got a 2 count.
I'm still at a loss for words what we just seen. That's going above and beyond what you're supposed to be.
Oh, exactly. And we're going to have to get somebody down there to talk to her at some point. But that was just disgusting.
Uh-oh, what's Harker got?
He's choking Jimmy Karryt out.
Oh, he's doing it right in front of her, too.
Oh, exactly. How fitting is that?
Oh, she is fired up, too. She's loving what Harker Dirge is doing.
It doesn't make up for the fact that he smashed her camera, but this definitely is sort of a, you know, a good treat for her.
Oh, you know, exactly.
You know, we always condone fans to bring their cameras, take their pictures and stuff, but, like, you know, someone like Jimmy Karryt, it makes you not want to do that. It makes you not want to sit there and enjoy it, but hopefully Harker, you know, takes care of business, and that young lady right there, you know, will get some kind of vengeance.
Speaking of fans, section. Fans need to be moving out of the way and watching out. This might spill into the outside in the crowd.
Anything could be used. Chairs, ladders, anything in the environment.
Up, where are they heading up? They're heading...
Oh, they're heading over to the merchandise tables.
Like they said, if they come near your path, folks, get out of the way.
Harker is all offense right now, just taking care of it around. Wait a second. Abdominal stretch in this type of match. Holy crap, a wrestling hold.
Dr. Nick, you were just proved wrong right there.
Yes, I was.
Abdominal stretch on the floor.
Harker Dirge's part, he's wearing him down.
In the merchandise area, this is not good.
Well, Jimmy Karryt just hip-tossed him off, and Harker Dirge hit nothing but floor.
I don't want to say it, but it looked like a desperation move by Jimmy Karryt almost.
Well, even if Jimmy Karryt would have gotten to a rope or something, there is no rope for him.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
He pulls that table out of the way. Wait a second. Oh, almost headbutt
into the wall.
Almost into Jason Voorhees himself. You better watch out for that machete.
Man, Jason Voorhees got a bird's eye view of that.
Oh, exactly.
He's got some type of moving cart.
Moving cart. That's what they brought the chairs in.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Incoming. Oh!
Harker Dirge slammed Jimmy Karryt on the cart.
And he kicked Jason on the way down. You don't do that. Pin attempt.
Man, Jason Voorhees. This is Friday the 13th, but he's getting a lot of action over
this
there.
This match is getting brutal.
That was the wrong Jason V to get his butt kicked here tonight.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Wait a second, incoming! Oh!
Somebody better check on Jimmy Karryt.
This crowd is going nuts.
Driven like a lawn dart into the steps, I believe.
Uh-oh, they're heading up here. They're heading up our way.
Oh, great. This is what I wanted.
John Stone, grab all the candy and let's pitch it out of here.
I already grabbed the candy.
No wonder I couldn't find it.
That's right. Up here in the stands.
I got a car waiting for me outside if I need to get out of here.
Dr. Nick, if they come over here, you might need a doctor. And they are, too. They're heading this way.
Oh, no.
And UWC, you never know how close to the action you might get.
Jimmy Karryt stopping to take a drink of something. I don't know. That was a fan's drink, I believe. Oh.
Oh, oh no.
Oh, oh boy.
Step back, no.
Come on.
Oh, no.
Come on.
I think he wants to throw him over the rail.
That's, no. Come on, you can only go so far.
Oh, no. Come on. Don't do it.
Don't do it, Jimmy.
Come on.
Think of the prison sentence. Don't do this.
Oh, Harker battled him back, though.
Oh, God.
Booth.
I didn't sign up for 3D wrestling. What is this? Go!
They are literally in our laps, folks.
No. Oh!
Oh my gosh!
Get this chair out of my way.
He's got a trash can.
Oh gosh. Oh!
Talk about up close and personal. I almost got attacked there by
Dr.
Jimmy Karryt.
You literally almost got taken out with a door.
Too much. I didn't want that.
I take my job seriously, and I'll definitely get in the action if I have to, but that was a little too close.
This is everywhere. This is literally what you call a false count anywhere match. Oh, Jimmy Karryt almost fell down the stairs.
I think we better have an ambulance on call for this.
We apologize. We can't really see the action right now because of all the fans. We will try to stay with it as much as we can.
So many people here that are following these two. Can't see the action that's going on, but I think one of them just went down the steps.
Did someone just go down?
I think so.
I think it was Jimmy Karryt, because Harker, Dirge is still standing.
Good assumption there.
You're welcome.
Something's going on. They're over by the front entrance.
The fans are cheering for them to go to the parking lot.
Oh, geez. No, my new vehicle's out there.
You mean your bicycle?
I guess. I'm going to need one if they get out there.
They're fighting by the ticket takers. They're out there by the front entrance.
This crowd is literally wanting them to go to the parking lot.
I can't get over this. I can't believe this. Somebody just went into the table.
Somebody just had a whistle.
Only a two count. I heard Mike Underwood scream two count. Oh, they're bringing it back to the ring, it looks like.
Just a sea of fans, you know, following this action. They love what they're seeing right now.
Look at Harker. Look at his back. Harker's...
Jimmy Karryt's back.
Oh, my God.
Both of these guys are definitely going to be worse for wear after this.
Harker is bleeding on his back from some lacerations. And... That's the type of thing Jimmy Karryt can do. He can take the beating of a lifetime, but one move will lay you out.
That's the type of the move that can cause some serious brain damage.
Irish whipping to the ropes. Harker reverses out of it. Ducks out of the back elbow. Sleeper.
We've seen this move incapacitate many opponents.
The crowd is still chanting parking lot.
Atomic drop. Northern Light suplex into a pin attempt.
This has been an amazing main event so far. The crowd loves it. What a way to end season two of UWC here at Now or Never.
Both men are down and for good right. Can't get over this so far.
To be up close to the action, but I think a little bit earlier that was a little bit too close to comfort.
Oh!
John Stone, you almost tripped over a chair. Nick, you almost got ran over by a door.
I didn't sign up for that tonight.
What?
I've had many doors shoved in my face, but it's usually by women.
Yeah, true story.
Jimmy Karryt is standing tall over the current champion. He wants that title.
Well, I guess what we seen a little while ago, that's the whole, you know, point of a false count anywhere match. It can go anywhere.
How ironic is it that the one thing these men are both fighting over is actually lying in the corner of the ring right now?
Absolutely. Oh!
Nice exploding clothesline.
This crowd loves it.
I think this obsession that Jimmy Karryt has with the UWC Championship is way beyond unhealthy.
Absolutely.
I'm just going to call it like I see it. The UWC Championship is the ring, and Jimmy Karryt is Gollum right now. That's his precious.
Are we going for a slingshot?
Oh, no.
The referee is in.
Wait a minute. Watch it. Oh!
Referee Mike Underwood gets caught in the crossfire.
Underwood is down. No referee here to count the pin. Harker, there's his move.
But there's
no one to count the pin.
Wait a minute,
20.
Shawn Rife. Looks like Shawn Rife making his way out to the ring. How fitting is this? Shawn Rife, wait a minute, pin attempt here.
Only a two count though.
How fitting is this? Shawn Rife has not officiated a Jimmy Karryt match ever since the I Quit match, and he took a kendo stick shot to the forehead.
We all remember that. That was brutal. Well, that shows the professionalism of Shawn Rife right there.
I can understand the uncomfortability he may have, but like you said, this man's a professional.
Wait. Steel chairs coming into play.
We got dueling steel chairs.
Oh, no. With that lacerated back.
Oh my.
Oh, what? God, Rife says no.
Rife taking the chair away. You gotta wonder what that's about. There's no disqualification in here.
Harker, Dirge, he's got the steel chair.
Take it back. Oh!
Dueling chair!
Oh. That's broken fingers written all over it.
More home runs and the Royals can hit in one season. Body drop.
I see what you just did there.
Wait a minute.
He hit the gold digger.
Gold digger wide. Could have it here.
Oh my gosh.
Harker Dirge kicks out of the gold digger.
Shoulder out at two.
Jimmy Karryt is beyond frustrated at this point. And now he's attacking the referee.
We saw what happened last time he got in Sean Rife's face. Rife took a kendo stick shot. Now there's steel chairs in there. I think Rife and the Mitter better just back down.
Absolutely, absolutely. Karryt saying it's over. Heading up to the top.
What? Lord, he misses the broad splash. Harker Dirge moves out of the way.
Jimmy Karryt was up in the upper deck, but he did not get anything. Harker knew where he was and moved out of the way.
Harker using the ropes to get back to his vertical base.
Karryt's got that steel chair again. Setting it up, maybe taking a breather.
This crowd is just off the hook here tonight at the Battle Zone. They've seen so much action. They're still wanting the parking lot.
Oh, I think he just broke him in half.
Out of the corner with the spear.
He's got him up! Oh!
There it is!
Spikes him down! That should be it!
It got him!
What a reaction!
My goodness!
This crowd is going crazy!
It's been 1 year since Harker Dirge first won the UWC Championship in that casket match. And now 1 year later, Halloween Horrors, Harker is still champion.
That was an amazing match. Congratulations to Harker Dirge retaining the UWC Championship. But at what cost? Neither one of these men are going to be the same after tonight.
What a way to end this season of UWC. UWC Online, all the big events we've had, all led up to this moment.
Oh my God, I'm exhausted. This
I
has
definitely
been...
got to get a Jimmy Karryt box, though. He took it to Harker like no one else ever has.
He did, but in the end, Harker shows, you know, why he is the champion and overcame everything Jimmy Karryt threw at him.
Oh, what a night we've had here tonight. A great way to cap off a fantastic season for all of us here at the United Wrestling Coalition, UWC Online, and all of you fans out there that continue to help us grow as a company and get bigger and bigger and bigger. Thank you so much. And don't forget to check us out. More action, facebook.com/UWC Georgetown. Sean, anything else to say?
I'm exhausted. I'm ready for bed after this.
All right, Dr. Nick.
Wow, this has been a great show, John. That's all I can say. I'm pumped up.
Well, for these two and myself, thank you very much for enjoying Now or Never. And come on out and check out UWC Online action anytime you get the chance.